So we're trying to study in general the mobile manipulation problem. So if you have a mobile robot, it needs to move around the workspace and pick up different objects to perform different tasks. Depending on the task and the objects that are there, you may want to grip it different ways. So we're trying to understand, you know, which is the best gripper to use for a particular task. And then once we know that, what's the best way to manipulate the gripper to figure out the perfect orientation for it, to grasp the part, where to grasp it, and then to execute that task.
We created a virtual environment with all the objects randomly dropped. We combined like different objects with complex geometries and shapes and textures. For example, we have bananas, apples, bottles, light bulb, some random cylinders, or some random 3D printed parts. So we want to do that is to create a challenging environment. Hopefully the robot can learn from this challenging environment and solve the similar question in the real world.
This work that we've been doing is for space. We want to go back to the moon, we want to go to Mars. In order to get there, we need to set up some habitats. And most of the time, these habitats will be unmanned, so the astronauts will not be there. There'll be robots that will need to be there to set everything up for them, do maintenance tasks, do repair tasks, setting up experiments for them, clearing cargo, putting cargo away. But these robots need to be able to identify the objects that they need to manipulate, figure out the best way to manipulate them and accomplish the task. When the humans are there, the astronauts are there, we want these robots to actually work with the humans as well to jointly carry out these different kinds of tasks. And so this could be a nice assistant for the astronauts while they're there.